I guess I was talking about in my mind when I was sitting here thinking about age and life and where we're going in the next scheme of things and what the current state is when you are at in your 50s or in your 60s or 70s, what it actually is like. Is it tangible anymore? Is it tangible as something that is of a value? I'm not talking monetary with the younger after. I'm talking the value of your existence, you know. Here it is on, you have the ramp up of what you've done in your life, you know. You've got that. Your list, I've done these things. And then there's the, you know, time to ponder about it and sit back on your laurels a little bit. All of that, you know, and then people say, what do you do or what did you do? And then there's that sentence and, you know, that you have to spiel out. So you have that. But that's really, it starts to become, well, it was really a then. You know, it was really a then. You know, the more and more retired you become, it was really a then. Was the back then. So you're talking like almost from a retrograde place. I want to use that. You're talking from, well, yeah, you know, I have that and I've done that and I, you know, I stand on that cloud. I stand on that pillar. I stand on that culmination, the culmination of events, of successes. I'm all of those things. You know, so packing that around, you know, that's what we pack around. Then as we're getting through to like all the time you have to pack that around, all the time that you have to say that, all the time it becomes like, I'm not making sense tonight, am I? My little black coin purse that's been stolen from me out of my handbag, so I'm a little bit upheavaled. I've had it for many years, so it's a shock and a sadness. Okay, so the escalate moments. Okay, so that's it. You know, you have your laurel rest, and so I'm like, okay. There's nothing more, you know, there's nothing more unless it's like, hurry, go do something else, you know. There's nothing more that really is comparing. And you can go and you can look at, you can say, oh, well, maybe there was a woman who made ties when she was 80 years old or something. She became a tie artist. And I'm like, well, good for her. You know, woo woo. You know, those are like really weirdo situations. I don't think they happen for many. I think most people are just like, that's it, I'm done. I'm life done. You know, I've done what I had to do. I can't do anymore. I think people become life done. And it's just like those snapshots, you know, you have a snapshot of those moments. And that's like, that's it. That's your draw. You know, that's your draw from. And so as we age, it just becomes like, that's it. Don't you get it? It's just it. That's the barrel. That's your pit of olives. your barrel of olive pit. That's it. That's all you get. You're not getting any more. It's just gonna be a, oh my gosh, quick, grab an olive out of that, there's something I did, you know, hurry, you know, but you're just always running back to that barrel, isn't it? And it's like so sick. It's so like sickening, isn't it? And you can say, oh, you're living in the past. Okay, well, screw you, because so are you. Everybody's living in the past. Everybody is running back to that barrel. Because what you did when you were young, what you did when you were 20, what you did when you were 25, what you did when you were 15, you know, all of those moments, those are the moments that we're like robbers of ourselves about, you know? We're like, oh, back then, you know? Oh, you know, we go back and grab those moments and go, oh, ooh, like we can almost steal our youth again, you know what I mean? Steal a piece of our youth and just like pluck it in into our heads, into our face and our bodies, you know? It's just like those moments are like, you know, extra funny if you were a performer. They were the stage moments of your life, you know? They were the moments when you were empowered, where you felt less, you were more risky. You could take riskier chances. You know, here we are, older, less risk. Gosh, less risk. So here you are, you're at this, I don't know, it's pathetic, isn't it? It's almost pathetic to be this age. Because it's just like, oh my God, I'm just dipping in at those olives of the past. It is becoming pathetic. And yet I'm so tired. I'm really tired. I'm exhausted that I can't go ahead and make some more little dancer drawings. I'm exhausted, you know, and that was the past even, you know, and that was 4 or 5 years ago. When I was making my dancer drawings, and that's an olive dip moment, don't you get it? I'm back there dipping at those ones. That was one. That was a greatness moment. But as I'm getting tired and more fatigued, and more malaised, and more like, oh my gosh, I don't think I'm gonna die tonight. But you know, it's starting to tick on me. Hey, you know, move over, enough of you already. We're tired of your age group around. Yeah, starting to get that push-shove from the young, where the interest held in the eyes, you know, is not there any longer. And so here is this, like, how do I actually have substantiality now, without going back to the barrel dip, you know, without going back to what you did before, you know? That's why I do like to Aria sing, because those moments are fresh. That's why I do like it. But this, gosh, this is terrible lighting. Sorry about that. Y'all have to look at all of my fine lines in this eye. I've always had fine lines, by the way. I don't know why. I didn't cry that much in my life. Just the way I'm manufactured. But when, what was I talking about? Yeah. The pathetic moments of return. Pathetic. And it's tough to not beat yourself up about it and go, oh, I'm living in the past. very tough, because we want to live in the past sometimes, you know, because that was it. That was when we were really, really young and able. That's not true. 3 years ago, was it three? It was about 2.5 years ago. I did Grand Jetés. I am not kidding you. I did full-on split Grand Jetés across a huge gym floor. And it was great. It was fabulous. I even did those ones, the Chinese ones where you go tandrian, tandrian, xia, or you call them the Russian padasha, the Chinese padasha time, where you do that. I did those. Those felt really amazing. But more amazing was Grand Jetés. Oh my gosh. I love them. Yeah. Anyway, that was 2.5 years ago. To really get up in the air, you know, in my pointe shoes. I'm in my pointe shoes, get up in the air and have that boing spring bounce, you know. That's the problem with being a dancer. It's just like, that was it, you know. And now, I'm just sitting here talking, you know, talking about it. You know, that was life in a way, you know what I mean? That was a life that I can't even express greater. That was so amazing. And I'm like, gosh, and when I was there in the studio, because I was building up to make those jetés, you know, I was building up, because I went to the gym, you know, as much as I could, but, you know, there was always, like, somebody spinning in a chair, like one of those bikes, or they were doing something, like, they were having some type of a wonton class, I don't know what it was, a zombie class, or zonkers, or they do something like that. And they're all like, oh, get out of my way! I'm exercising. They're doing those things, and meanwhile, I'm trying to be ballerina because I have no money, and that's like the only place that I could actually put my pointe shoes on and spin around, and so I had built up, you know, weaving and coercing through. Usually, people weren't around that much. I did have the place to myself a lot, but I had built up to Grand Jetés, and I actually only did them one day, I'm not kidding you, one day. And things after that, just, I couldn't go, my truck broke, I mean, everything was just like, are you kidding me? I just like, built up to Grand Jetés, and it just like, quicksand. My whole life became quicksand. The truck went into the quicksand. There was a mean kid there at the gym that was just aggressive to me for no reason, like somebody paid him to be, and he kept punching a punching bag, and hurting my ears. And I'm like, well, this is really sick. This has become a sick flick. So I was like, well, I got to get out of here. So I couldn't even go to the gym anymore. So I built up to make Grand Jetés, and it was almost like a killing. Like they're just trying to kill me from dancing. So anyway, I can't stand it. I think maybe the guy was making drug deals there or something, and he wanted me out of the room because he had to make drug deals. I don't know. People and their stupid, pathetic drugs. I can't stand it. It was like some kid knocked on the door tonight, and he gives me this spiel, like, oh, I need some money for this, and, you know, and I'm like, wait a minute, this kid is like, he's got these eyes going this way and that way, and I'm starting to feel preyed upon, and I'm like, no. Oh, no. And, yeah, dang it. So I'm not opening the door at night anymore. Forget it. Nasty bastard showing up and wanting money. And any hoot. So what? Yeah, and that's like the new now. That's my new reality. Mrs. Hades here, living in Hades. They took my beautiful little coin purse. My beautiful coin purse. My mother gave me that coin purse. My mother's dead now. And so whoever has it, my God, you know, you're gonna get some bad omens. Anyway, so what I'm talking about, what was I talking about? The reason, the past cling, you know, we're over there, back to the barrel. I do this, and I did that, and I did this other. And I'm, you know, I do the past live just off of, you know, like I was telling you about my grand jeté 2.5 years ago. And back then, you know, 2.5 years ago, I was even doing, I worked up to a triple pirouettes. Oh my God. You know, so I was feeling like in the groove of myself. And so I was tapping into when I was 25, you know. And when you start to tap into when you're 25 again, oh my God, it's amazing. And maybe that was what it was. You know, maybe I'm not allowed to tap into when I was 25. Maybe there was some resentment. I don't know. Just feels like I've been hounded and chased. And put in that, the quicksand. My truck has been put in that quicksand. All of these things. So. I can't obtain my 25 again? Jerks. I mean, my gosh, you would think I was like La Femme Nikita or something, you know? And they have like some secret code out there, and like, you have to get her. She is not allowed to dance. She is not allowed to succeed because she's La Femme Nikita. Watch out. My gosh, you know, I'm not even a gun handler. Not really. I used a gun one time in a ballet. One time. It was very loud, and I didn't actually like it. I didn't like that piece because the gunfire was too close to my ears, and I didn't have any kind of headset. It was really close range. Anyway, yeah, those are weird ballets when you get to shoot other dancers on stage. Only in Germany can you shoot another dancer on stage and get away with it. But yeah, but that's my point. There was a barrel, an olive barrel. I just plucked one out. And that doesn't make you young to talk about when you were young. But for a moment, it's like a thief of yourself, isn't it? It's like I'm stealing that. That I'm talking about myself. I'm going to steal. You know what I'm saying? Steal a little bit of that energy. And you're like, well, it's your life. You know, why can't I talk about it? Why can't I steal that energy? Well, I don't know. I hate to say it, but the past liver, I always use this, gosh, I'm looking really fat in this light. The past liver is what? Does it actually reach into your blood circulation liver, your real physical one? When you're talking about the past so much, does the brain get like, hey, I'm upset by this? This is old data, you know? And so am I gonna just swirl your whole body now? I'm gonna go up and down through your toes. But this is just old data, rancid data. And so re-liver, you know, because here's the blood, it goes through your liver, you know, it filters it and goes through again and again and filters it again and again. It's like, well, And the brain is going, but you're just living in the past, dear. And that's old data. So here goes the old data again. And I'm like, well, maybe I don't want to do the old data anymore. I'm bored. It's not that exciting to filter. And so it's going to go through and go, ugh, and go sluggish liver. Oh, not this again. Not this story. You know, the story, that one? I hate that story, says the brain. I mean, come on. And so there it is. And then there's slug liver. So here's my liver going sluggish liver because I keep telling that same story. I do you know these people who keep telling the same story? I know a few. And she did this and he did that and this happened and it went on and on and on and on. But isn't that the brain just going like, there must be a part in the brain that knows that that's a repeat. You've already said it. That is a rerun. You're sending rerun into the brain. Okay, so here's your blood. It's working through. It's going somewhere in there. It's catching into a knowledge that there's a rerun happening. So this has always been my theory that it upsets our liver. This living in the past. Now, there are those that really live in the past. Wow. And I mean everything, like, you know, like when they're like 18 years old and their room was set a certain way. I mean, that way. I mean, there are people that really live in the past. They won't even step out from no, my mother gave me those little tiny little booties, you know, for Christmas, and so they hang there in that space for 40 years, 50 years, 60 years, 80 years. You know, there are those types of people, and that's a real odd type. But that's a person who really, really is living in the past. That in a way, they don't ever allow it to become the past, you know what I mean? They allow it to just stay the constant. Okay, well anyway, did I make any sense tonight? I think so. I was talking about the past, grabbing into that barrel of olives. I ate like four olives tonight, so yeah, grabbing into that barrel of olives and how it brings back the charge up. Ah, when I did this, I was so amazing. Or maybe I wasn't, but it doesn't matter. It felt amazing, and it still feels amazing now. Oh my gosh. So yeah. And unfortunately, if that's where our happiness, like our real, like our happy vibe up, if our real happy vibe up is happening from that time, and that grab back, you know, that was so great, you know, I am just enthralled to remember it again, you know, I'm thrilled, it's just, wow, I'm wired, I'm hyped. It's just like a drug. It's a drug to pull into those heights of your past. That it's an addiction, isn't it? It starts to become an addiction. Why would I ever stop talking about that? Why would I ever stop trying to draw a pull from those moments? That's like my life crack, if you would say it, you know, to be an addict. That's your life, what do you call it? Um, there's a word, is it manja? Your life food? I don't like to use the drug issues. It could be like your life food. Your food. You get fed by it, you know, your brain is fed by it. But it's still being fed by something that happened maybe even 20 years ago, or 30 or 40 years ago, or 50 or 80, you know, if you're 90 years old. You know, sometimes those 80s and 90 year old ones, they go back to when they were 10 years old. It's like my dad, he likes to relive a story when he was like 10 years old. And that's, you know, it's like, okay, there's nothing you can do about it, you know, that it is like a live energy source that is so exciting for that person. So exciting, I cannot believe it. So I don't know, when it comes to healthy, we're supposed to like keep the energy pull moments, keep those moments that you're really hyped about, keep those happening later in your life, as late as possible. I guess that's why men run around and have their midlife crisis at 40. I didn't get the woman with the really long legs. Maybe that's what the midlife crisis is about, you know, because when they become 60, they're not going to have anything to draw on, nothing. You know, only had a woman that didn't have the really long legs. Anyway. How boring. Yeah, men are really boring me at the moment, but that's really it. I don't know. I don't want to talk about them. No. Just about my grand jetés 2.5 years ago, and they were thrilling.